Glad to be with you, Cassia, and I can't tell you how much I've appreciated listening to this diverse group of United Front type folks. I'm representing the new document called the Manifesto for Our Times, the Challenge to Abolish Systemic Racism. It's a text that you'll see on screen. We're asking the whole world to sign, thousands of people, and it was initiated by Alice Walker, Umia Abu-Jamal, Glenn Ford, Pam Africa, myself, and many other people. My own credentials, I'm the director of the Mobilization to Free Umia Abu-Jamal, have been for 35 years. I'm on the administrative committee of UNEC. I'm the national secretary of the political party Socialist Action and its candidate for the presidency in 2020. I am on the National Steering Committee of the Committee to Defend Julian Assange and Civil Liberties, and a founder of the Northern California Climate Mobilization. I'd like to read just a few, if I may, sections of the manifesto, if I could find it. Joe, why don't you take that off the screen so I can read sections of the manifesto that you're hiding. Great, thanks, Joe. So, the manifesto is a lengthy document initiated by Alice and Mumia, myself and others. And there's a section called, Where Do We Go From Here? We begin with the proposition that the term police reform is an oxymoron. Derek Chauvin's knee has been on our necks for four centuries. His police ancestors were the slave patrols of yesteryear, formed to track down escaped slaves. They were the post-Civil War police who arrested en masse Black Code designated vagrants turned into instant prisoners, transformed to plantation chain gangs to work for free for former slave owners. They were the racist Bill Connor heads of Birmingham's Public Safety Commission, hired to enforce the state's separate but equal Jim Crow laws. They were and remain the scab herding cops employed to break union strikes and club civil rights demonstrators. They were all part of the system's inherent function to maintain the social order of the few against the vast majority. Abolitionist Frederick Douglass said it well, power concedes nothing without a demand. It never did and never will. Malcolm X, a century later, came to the same conclusion. Power never takes a back step, only in the face of more power. Malcolm added, prophetically, I might say, I believe that there will be a clash between those who want freedom and justice and equality for everyone and those who want to continue the system of exploitation. The objective of this manifesto is to keep the movement in the streets, which is why we're all here today. That is not to subordinate it to once every 4 years voting for which of the twin parties of capital will oppress us. In order to do that, we need to stay in the streets. We need to stay united. We need to pick the key issues of our time. We need to empower ourselves, the vast majority. I'll say this in conclusion. The CNN did a poll and it said that 84% of the nation supported the mass protests against systemic racism. That's an unprecedented number. That's an example of not only the most oppressed coming to the streets, but their black and but their white brothers and sisters joining the struggle and accepting that a new leadership is on the march. Let's stay together. Let's work together in united front formations. Let's show that the majority is with us and not the tiny elite that rule the country. Thank you so much. Sign our statement. Our next speaker, I'm happy to introduce, is Ike Nahum with CubaC. Ike, take it away.